Hi everyone, Jeremy Shafer here. I got a request to make a tutorial for my origami dragon. This is a model that I designed a long time ago and published in my origami book, Origami to Astonish and Amuse. This model is from a 10-inch sheet of Japanese foil, and I painted the white side with acrylic paint using sponge technique. But I'm not going to show that. I'm just going to show you how to fold it from a basic 10-inch square sheet of kami. So we're going to start out with a bird base. So turn the paper over and fold in half. And half the other way. Now this is how I like to make a preliminary base. What we do is fold this edge up to this crease. And turn over and fold this edge up to this crease. Alright, rotate, and we're going to open up this pocket right here. So open up the pocket and put your fingers all the way to the back and flatten it down, like this. And this is a preliminary base. Now we're going to turn it into a bird base. So we start out, we fold this edge right to the middle crease. And same thing on the other three flaps. So here we go. And turn it over. And last flap. Now fold this flap up. Get it all the way up there. And rotate. And unfold these two side flaps, but you can leave the top down. And we're going to make a petal fold. So this is how I like to explain it. It's like opening up here, and it forms a boat. You see the boat? And we're going to collapse the sides of the boat. Like that, and like that. Turn over, and we're going to make another petal fold right here. So open up the flaps. And fold this flap down, that will help. And lift up. My fingers are all the way in the back. Lift up and form the boat. And flatten. Here's a bird base. Let's bring the flaps down. Alright, so we're going to sink this corner. So fold it right down this flap. Like that. And you can fold it the other way too. Reverse the fold. That'll help sink easier. Alright, here goes. You have to unfold it See how there's a square there? Square of creases. We're going to go around that square with our pinchers and make mountain folds. Notice how my other hand is underneath, offering support. It goes pinch, pinch, pinch. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Okay, now bring the four corners together. We have this square here. We're going to push the middle of the square inside. And the model returns. The bird base. Alright, rotate it, and we're going to fold these corners. So the fold originates here and terminates there. Same on the left. Turn over. Same thing. Rotate and fold this flap up here. Turn over and fold this flap up. And fold one flap to the left. Turn over. And again, one flap left. That's called a minor miracle fold. Alright, now comes the tricky fold. We're going to make a reverse fold. We're going to reverse fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this crease. So, if you want, you can first do a valley fold. This is if you're a beginner, showing you how to make a reverse fold, but hopefully soon you'll be able to get away from the training wheels, so to speak. So unfold, and we're going to fold inside now. Well, if you want, you can first make a mountain fold. That's the training wheel. Okay, there we go. Mountain fold, and I'm assuming that you've never done a reverse fold, but this is a pretty basic fold in origami, so it's a good thing to learn. Alright, and there is the reverse fold. Now this is how to do a reverse fold without using the pre-creases. You open up, and I'm going to fold this edge along here, so that this crease ends up right on that edge. Okay, and reverse the crease, which used to be a mountain fold, now it's a valley fold. Is the reverse fold. Alright, bring this flap up and turn over, same thing. Now we're going to make a rabbit ear on this flap. So first fold this edge. Let's turn it over. Let's rotate it. Let's rotate. Okay. So we're going to make a rabbit ear on this flap. Like this. We're folding this edge up to this edge. And this edge goes up to this edge. Now we're going to fold this edge to this edge, making a valley in between. This is called a wrinkle fold, where I'm just adjusting my fold slightly to make it a little bit cleaner. Okay. And now we're going to make all three at the same time. So this folds together and folds up. And let's fold it to the right. And turn over, and we're going to do the same thing here. I'm going to do a little bit faster. One, two, and three. Well, I guess a lot faster. Okay, rotate. Now, and turn over. And we're going to fold this flap to the left. Just like that. That fold is perpendicular to the bottom edge. Alright, I'm going to get closer so you can see this next fold. We're going to fold this edge so that it lies along this edge. And it's just the front layer. So reach in and see how the edges align? And folds right to here. This does not lie flat, obviously. And we're going to flatten it now. We're going to flatten this edge so that it goes along the bottom edge. Like that. And now we're going to fold this flap right here so that this edge lies on that line. And this is the wing of the dragon. Well, the wing to be anyway. And turn it over. We're going to do the same thing on this side. So, starts out. Fold this flap. And this edge goes up. Lies right along that edge. And flatten it down. And fold this edge so that it lies on this edge. So the wings line up. And you can pull these forward. These are the arms. And do the same thing on the back side. Okay. Now we're going to make a reverse fold. And on this reverse fold, this edge is going to align with the bottom. So I'm opening it up a little bit here. And making a valley fold. Goes all the way to the tip of the tail. And the other part of it is this edge aligns with this edge. And where those two folds meet is right there. And flatten. And turn over and repeat. So, I'm gonna do this a little bit faster. Hopefully you got the hang of it. And we're also going to do the same thing on the front. All right. now we're going to make a rabbit ear on this corner right here. So let's get a little bit closer so you see what I'm doing. So you fold it down first. Like that. And fold it up. Like that. And pinch it. Rabbit ears consist of three folds that converge. And there's one arm. Repeat on the back side. Alright, turn over. Alright, fold this wing down here. And we're going to fold so that this corner goes to right here. Get a little bit closer here. So now we're going to make a valley fold that goes in between this fold and that fold. So, see how the folds line up? Right there. And we're also going to make a fold between this fold and that fold. And we have to make folds that bisect all of these angles. So let's start out with the outside one. And now the one that goes in between here. Notice how I'm able to fold this edge right to there. Bisect here. And right here. See? That's another bisection. And last one, right here. This fold goes to there. So now we come up like this, and let's turn it over. I'm going to do the same thing. So unfold, and here first, then here. Edge. That's. We have four. One, two, three, four sections. Divide it into eight. So we'll start right here with this section. Fold this crease to there. Next. See how the flap is divided into eight sections. So fold it up. Now we're going to bring all of these folds together so that we're making pleats. So rotate it. And what that means is that we're going to take this, the crease right here, and fold it. Here. The camera is going to have a struggle seeing this. Okay. I need a new camera. It hurt me. Okay. Hello. Okay. So, once again, what I did is I folded this crease up to here. And the next one, we form it and fold it on to there. Next is here and fold it. Sun just came out. It's been raining 4 days straight, which is unusual for Berkeley. Okay, and here we have an ubenico, a fan. Well, actually a wing, hopefully. And I know this is way too detailed, but we're going to make little reverse folds on all 8 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of these folds. There's no way the camera's going to let me do this, but get an idea, at least. I wish I had a microscopic lens that could really zoom this up, but oh well. I also wish I had smaller fingers, right? I like fingers where you could just press a button and they get small. That would be nice. As long as you could press the button to make them large again. Is a little bit easier to work with when it comes to tiny pleats and tiny reverse folds. Alright, and there is one wing. Ooh, the dragon wing. Alright, so do the same thing on this side. Thank you. they're done. Now we're going to make a swivel fold. So this edge right here is going to go so that it aligns with the wing. So fold it right in like that. And at the bottom here, just make a little squash. Same thing on the other side. This edge aligns with the wing. Okay. Now with the hind leg, let's bring it forward. How far? This is sort of to taste. No, actually there is a crease here in the bottom of the tail. I mean, the base of the tail, right here. Fold right to there. And over here, fold so that it lines up with the crease below it. Okay, unfold it. Okay, we're going to fold this corner right here so that it aligns with the dragon wing too. So the fold originates here and terminates there. Same thing on the other side. Holding this flap up. And turn it over again. Alright, now we're going to fold this flap over so that the fold lines up with that crease underneath there. Same thing on the other side. And open it up, and we're going to put a crimp right here so that the tail rotates up this direction. So open it up and just bend the tail so that it points upward. And now we're going to put a bunch of pleats into the tail and the neck. So the way this works is pleats are generally kind of hard to do, but this is a little trick. Let's undo that fold that we just did. Okay. We're going to put about 7 mountain folds right on this tail. So start. Doesn't really matter. About like that. 1, 2. Try to make them perpendicular to this crease. 3. And try to make them progressively get closer together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And here comes our neighbor's dog. Welcome, welcome. Okay. And I'm going to take these folds and fold them up so that we're making a pleat. And once again, pleat this up. Maybe I should get a little closer so you can see this pleat. The camera will let me. little pleats on all seven of the creases, and these pleats should be as small as possible. And fold it back up. Now be careful when you fold this back up that you don't rip the paper. So how do you do that? You want to try to squeeze at the bottom as you fold it up so that the paper adjusts to the new crease. If you just squeeze there without first squeezing here, you could rip the paper. You might rip the paper anyway, but okay. And there's the pleat. And what we do now is that we're going to bend the tail. Let's put in our crimp that we did at the beginning. It's the first one. And instead of bending it up, what we're going to do is pull out this pleat very carefully, like that, and refold. And you see how the end product is a crimp. So again, over here, pull this out. Now, if you kept on doing that, the tail would bend all the way up. But let's put a crimp going the other direction. So to go the other direction, you just pull out the tail a little bit and flat. And let's do one more pull down. So you see how the tail bends up and bends down. And the last two, oops, one of mine came out. The last two, let's make it bend up. One. And, well, the last one, don't even need to do anything with it because we need to make the arrow at the end of the arrowhead at the end of the dragon's tail. In fact, let's do that right now. So what you do is you're going to take this edge and pull it out like that. And same thing on the other side. Okay, and now we're going to make a reverse fold on this flap right here. So it reverses right like that. By the way, you can pull out the tail a little bit more. Now. Okay. Out that last crimp. So now we're going to reverse fold it again. And again. All else fails, just shape it so that you have an arrowhead right there. And wrap the arrow around the tail. Let's turn over. And we're going to three-dimensionalize the tail. So that means that we're going to make these edges round, just shaping it so that it's a tube. let's see, this fold right here can get, this flap can get folded back inside. Same thing over here. And now time for the neck. We got the tail looking okay. Oh, we can make the legs also. It's kind of fun. Just pinch them, shape them. Same thing on the other side. Okay. And the wing comes up. And the other wing is somewhere around here. There it is. Okay, let's do the head now. So we open it up. And make our seven mountain folds. Seven mountain creases. So starting right around here. There's not a guideline for this. Let's try to make it perpendicular to the center crease. And progressively get smaller. So start out with a sort of a big pleat. Just slightly smaller. They can be pretty much the same. And it doesn't need to be seven, you can make more, so. Or less. That's four. So you notice how they're just slightly smaller, if at all. One, two, three, four. 7 wonders of the world. Just 7 wonders of the dragon's creases. 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 These folds back inside. Give little pleats. If anyone wants to give me some camera tips, I'd appreciate it. Why you think it's getting blurry all of a sudden? Okay. And fold it in half. Making sure to first squeeze here. Flattening it. Somehow this ended up curving downward. Well, we're actually going to curve it upwards. All pleats are going to pull out. Alright, and there are the crimps. Okay, I'm going to make a reverse fold right here. Okay, there's the head, but it's very narrow. So we have to pull out paper from inside. And over here. Try to keep the raw edges inside. There is the head. Let's shape it by pinching. There. See? And fold the tip inside. There's the head. Kind of like a duck, but oh well. If you want, you can try to make actual nostrils by opening out the corner, but I'm not going to do that for now. Okay, and fold the corners of the wings to the outside. And, ooh, the sun came out again. Kind of made a small head. Oh well. And with magic, I'm going to make the head bigger. Wow, magical. And there we have it, the dragon. Pull out the wings a little bit. You can make it come forward at these points. That looks actually a little bit nicer. It's an action model. So there you have it, the origami dragon. And, well, what can you do with it? Well, if you make another one, you can have them battle. Or maybe hug. Okay, no, this is G-rated. Battle. I don't know why that's G-rated, but oh well. Okay, goodbye. Happy folding, and don't forget to subscribe to Jeremy Shafer Origami. Later.